Good. What day is it? It's Tuesday or is it Wednesday? It's Tuesday. All these days are running together. That's a heck of a start of a broadcast, isn't it? Welcome into Charger Athletics here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. We're streaming on Zone. Where are we? We're on Zone 2, like we're supposed to be. Beautiful, picturesque afternoon here at Charger Park for a non-conference conference matchup. Yeah. The Warhawks from AUM have come up from the capital city to take on the UAH Chargers. UAH 15-11 on the campaign, 4-8 in GSC play, while the Warhawks, they are right at the Mendoza line, 14-14 on the year, 9-6 though in GSC play, as the Chargers are looking for a little momentum here. On the bump here this afternoon for the Chargers is Connor Edwards. And for Connor on the season, taking a look at his numbers, an ERA of 3.27. And this is his ninth overall appearance through 11 innings, 16 hits that he's given up, 5 runs, 4 of them earned. And he has also just given up 1 home run on the year. And away we go with that one darted right up the middle there by Friedman on the first pitch that he faces here in the top of the first. So one batter, one pitch, one hit there for the Warhawks as they have a runner on base. Didn't get a chance to even tell you the rundown here for AUM. That is Nick Friedman. As coming up next will be Stanch, the first baseman for the Warhawks. He'll dig into the right-handed batter's box. First pitch by Edwards is a little toss over to first. Don't let that bathed sun fool you. It's a little chilly here in North Alabama. First pitch outside for ball one. Season well underway. Like to joke with the baseball folks, when we turn the calendar, wait for that first snow to come in. That's the way we all know it's baseball season. The 1-0. Outside, 2-0. Just getting things started here. Top of the first. Freeman liked the first pitch that he saw and drove it right up the heart of the diamond. And that's in there for a strike right at the belt buckle that time by Edwards. Count goes to 2-1. Set at the belt. The 2-1. Low and inside right on top of the shoelaces. Count goes to 3-1. The 3-1, low and outside, so back-to-back Warhawks get on base right out of the gate here. Freeman advances to second, and here comes Franklin. Next up, and Franklin batting .283 on the year. Wind blowing out towards right center field. 2-1, nobody out. Did that deflect off the bat? I guess not. It popped off of the mitt by Wendell, and that advances the runners, and all of a sudden, two runners in scoring position for the Warhawks here in the top of the first. Edwards is set. Pitch to Franklin low for ball one. Connor Edwards takes a little time to regroup before he climbs back up on the hill. The 2-0 swung on and missed. Right in by the knuckles. Nice pitch on that heater. Count goes to 2-1. Two on, nobody out. The 2-2, little tapper to second. Backhanded stab on to first in time. A run does score. So sacrifice there, but nonetheless a run score. But out number one on the 4-3 put out. And that'll bring up Thomas as Ashton Thomas batting .333 on the year. One home run, 12 runs driven in. Plays left field for the Warhawks. That's right down the heart of the plate for strike one. Already an early mess here as Edwards tries to clean it up with just one run scored so far. Let's hope we can keep it that way. The 0-1 gets away on a wild pitch. And it's now 2-0 Warhawks. So two runs, one hit. And actually, that was the very first pitch of this top of the first. On the very first pitch that Freeman saw to start off this game here this afternoon. Edwards is set. The 1-1 inside for ball two. A lot going on campus here. The 2-1. A little low for ball three. Good eye by Thomas, and Purvis would be next. Well, it is going to be next. There's only one out here in the top of the first. Outfield play is pretty straight away, but medium deep. 3-1, tapper over the mound, had eyeballs on that one. Sneaks into center field. Where Upton fires it back in. So another runner on base for AUM. And that'll bring up Nick Purvis. Batting .182 on the year, but he has only played seven games so far this season for the Warhawks. That's launched down the right field line, giving it a run the right fielder, and squeezes it right at the line. That's out number two. Well done that time by Wilburn out there in right field to chase that down for out number two. So Garam Seaman. Runner on first, two out. Edwards is set at the belt. First pitch is a little toss over to first. Thomas stays put. This is the sixth batter of the inning for the Warhawks here in the top of the first as they lead it 2-0. Trying to keep it that way. First pitch inside, gets away, and that rolls into center and staying put. There is Thomas. Another wild pitch, and fortunately did not lose another base off of that ball slipping in between short and second. So another runner in scoring position here for AUM, their third of this first half inning. High and outside for ball two. The 2-0 pitch. Here it comes. That's right down the heart of the plate for strike one. Christian Moffitt calling balls and strikes here this afternoon. The 2-1. Are they going to appeal? No appeal. Guess he held up. Count goes to 3-1. Two have already scored here in the top of the first for AUM. They lead it 2-0. The 3-1. He swung at that one and could not hold on to that bat right there. Count runs full at 3-2 for Connor Edwards. Getting the starting nod for head coach Hunter Royer's squad here this Tuesday afternoon. The 3-2. Outside ball four, second walk of the inning for Edwards. And the inning will continue, but a meeting on the mound here as all of a sudden, this is the fourth different runner on base for AUM here in this top of the first. Edwards on the season kind of went over his numbers a little bit, but taking a closer look at it, this is his ninth appearance through 11 innings. He's given up 16 hits. 5 runs, 4 of them earned, 3 walks, 4 strikeouts. He has given up one triple and one home run on the year. Opposition batting 348 against him. He has hit 2 batters as well. Just trying to find his control as Connor Edwards for the Chargers. Junior out of Gurley, Alabama. Right up the road here from Huntsville. Soul next up for AUM. This is the 7th different batter for AUM right out of the gate as they lead it 2-0. They've got 2 more base runners on, but there's 2 outs. First pitch to Soul outside for ball 1. The 1-0. A little low, ball 2. Matthew Del Sol is batting 160 on the season. The 2-0, high and outside for ball 3. Another bad one would load it up. Certainly don't want to lay a fat one right down the heart of the plate, but I'm not sure Connor's got much of a choice here. The 3-0, right down the heart of the plate for strike 1. Let's see what kind of pitch we're going to get here out of Connor. Runners on first and second for the Warhawks. 2 outs, top of the first. The 3-1, outside, they're loaded. Back-to-back walks has loaded him up. Here comes Greer. Hayden Greer batting 182 on the season. Love to see a first pitch strike right here. Here it comes. That's in there for strike 1. Painting the back black of the plate right there. Nice pitch by Edwards. So AUM threatening to put up a big number here. Let's see if we can get out of it. The 0-1. Launched into center field, but Campen under it is Upton, and he'll squeeze it for out number 3, thankfully. 2 runs, 2 hits. Couple of wild pitches. 3 big runners left for AUM. We've played a half an inning. It's Warhawks 2, Chargers coming up.
Bob Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's North Alabama Mortgage.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Back here at Charger Park, Steve Moulton here with you on a Tuesday afternoon. Chargers trailing at 2-0 as we head to the bottom of the first. And due up, it'll be Carter, Vialta, and Butler out of the gate for the Chargers. Carson Beach is on the mound for AUM. His numbers on the year, a 9.45 ERA. This is his seventh appearance of the year, his first start of the year. Threw 6 2/3 innings, 13 hits, 11 runs, 7 of them earned. He's walked 4, struck out 7, has given up 3 doubles, and 2 dingers on the year, of opposition batting 406. So hopefully Chargers can add to those numbers, and Merrick Carter going to try to start things off the right way. Things certainly started off the right way for AUM, as Freeman on the very first pitch he saw drove it right back where it came from. First pitch for the Chargers is low for ball one. Carter batting 447 on the year. This is his 25th appearance of the year. He's played in every single game. The 1-0 is high for ball two. 3 long ones, 23 runs driven in. 4 of 5 on the base paths as well, so good speed as well for Carter. Let's get you on. The 2-0 inside for ball three. 3 straight balls by Beach out of the gate. Chargers trailing it 2-0. The 3-0. Inside, walked him on 4 straight. Carter trots down to first, as I mentioned. Has 4 stolen bases on the year, but honestly, let's just see what's going to happen here with Carson Vialta. Carson batting 372 on the season.
You go 1-3.
1 home run, 19 runs driven in on the year. That's inside. Ball 5. If you've seen the movie Major League, you know what I'm referencing. Make him throw you a strike, Carson. The 1-0. It's in there for called strike one, right at the belt buckle. Count goes to 1-1. Now dig in. Tying run is at home plate, despite all the traffic that we saw in the top of the first. The 1-1. Tip foul. That was off of his toenails. Count goes to 1-2. Brock Butler on deck, the designated hitter. A little snap throw to first. Sliding back safely is Carter. not a cloud in the sky above us. But don't let it fool you. It's a little chilly. We got a story about that. The 1-2. Inside ball two. Count goes to 2-2. Carver gets a little bigger lead at first. Snap throw again, sliding back safely again is Carter. So it's currently 55 degrees here in Huntsville. Says it feels like 52. The 2-2. That hit him. Bialta gonna trot down to first, and all of a sudden, two on, nobody out here for the Chargers in the home half of the first. And here comes the aforementioned Brock Butler, and appearing in his 22nd game this year for the Chargers, batting 360 on the season. Four home runs, 18 runs driven in.
Go for it.
There's the pitch. Kind of a little off speed, but finds a home there behind the plate for strike one. Tying run is at first. Go-ahead run is Mr. Butler. The 0-1. Low for ball one. A walk and a hit batter. So both Beach and Edwards trying to labor through some early trouble.
RBI now, here you go.
The 1-1. Low and outside. Nicely dug out that time by Greer behind home plate for the Warhawks. Wilburn on deck.
Wait on it, wait on it.
The 2-1. Hammer down the left field line. This is going to score at least one. Carter rounds third. He'll head home. It's 2-1. Now trying to dig it in is Vialta. He'll score. No slide needed. That is right cradling the baby out there is Butler. We're tied at two with nobody out here in the home half of the first. Here comes J.C. Wilburn. Wilburn batting 345 on the year, two home runs, 14 runs driven in.
RBI, babe.
Still nobody out. First pitch to JC. Held, and it's a ball inside. Count goes to 1-0. Junior out of Helena, Alabama. Not Helena. The 1-0. Swung on and missed. Healthy cut that time for Wilburn.
Easy, easy, here you go.
Beach continues out on the mound. Right-hander is set. Here's the 1-1. That's launched into center field. Camping under it, though. There is Freeman. He'll squeeze it, but runner does tag, and Wilburn ends up at third with one out here in the bottom of the first. I'll bring up Jackson Lindsay. Lindsay batting 283 on the year. One home run, 18 runs driven in. Go-ahead run is at third base. Beach is set at the belt. Swung on and missed by Lindsay. Count goes to 0-1. Plenty more baseball and softball coming up as that swung on and missed. Swung at ball one. Gave Beach a favor right there. Out of the strike zone. Charger Park will be hopping this weekend. The 0-2 swung on and missed. Good morning, good afternoon, and good night there for Mr. Lindsay. Second out of this home half of the first. Let's see if whether or not we can bring in that go-ahead run. Going to take a two-out hit. Reagan up next.
Get him in now. You go 4-2.
Batting 400 on the season. It's in there for called strike one. All of a sudden, okay? Beach has got himself a little hop in that pitch and motion, I should say. And he's ahead in the count again, 0-1. The 0-1. Little roller to short, gobbled up, fired it on to first. It's a nice scoop out that time defensively, Stash, but that'll do it for the Chargers here in the first. But two runs score. On one hit, no errors. There was a Charger left. We're through one. We're tied at two here at Charger Park.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
It will be 9-1-2 due up for the Warhawks here in the top of the second. Steve Moulton back here with you in Charger Park. So I did mention I had a little story time for you weather-wise, and it looks gorgeous. It's a little chilly, not bad. But traveling with the basketball team, tunnel is up right out of the gate here. Takes a look at ball one outside. Tunnel batting 230 on the season. No home runs. 8 runs driven in as Edwards starts his second inning of work as that went off the nub of the bat and a little sliding in. He slides it in and he's out of there. A 3-1 put out. Nicely done by Edwards. Getting there first. So out number one here in the top of the second. So I was traveling with the basketball team down to Fort Lauderdale for the NCAA tournament. And I don't know why. I think I watch more local news when I'm away from Huntsville. Freeman belted the first pitch he saw right through center field, but he takes a look at strike one. So the 0-1 pitch. Bounces in front, count goes to 1-1. So I'm watching the local news down in Miami. And for those of you that live in the Huntsville area, you know that weather's a big deal up here. Well, the weatherman looked in the camera, the 1-1 high and inside for a little chin music. And it was as if a tornado warning had been fired off in Miami, because the weatherman looked in the camera and said, I've got some major news to tell you. The 2-1, little roller to second, on one hop on to first in time. Two up, two down. This story is yielding out, so I'm going to drag this on as long as I can.
You got 2-8?
So the weatherman looks into the camera and says, I've got some major news for you here. It's going to get down to 59 degrees Tuesday morning. So even though spring is supposed to sprung tonight, don't pack up your sweaters just yet.
Nice.
I hope everyone in South Florida is doing all right with the cold conditions. The 0-1 fouled away down the right field line.
Go, 2-8. Here we go.
They will survive. No balls, two strikes. How about a 1-2-3 inning for Mr. Edwards? He's one strike away. That's high and outside for ball one. Not a bad idea right there. Certainly want to congratulate Nova Southeastern and Florida Southern. They're actually playing tonight in a Sweet 16 game there at Nova. That's hammered to center field. Upton is there. How about a 1-2-3 inning? Atta baby. No runs, no hits, no errors. No Warhawks left. We're through an inning and a half. 2-2 here at Charger Park.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care. Specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Head to the home half of the second here at Charger Park on a glorious Tuesday afternoon. Chargers will bring up 7, 8, and 9. Hunter Tillman first up out of the gate. Tillman batting .275 on the season. No home runs, 10 runs driven in for Hunter.
Go nine.
First pitch, squaring to bunt down the third baseline, scooped and off of the heel of the glove. Where are we going here? Infield hit. I like it a lot. So an infield hit for Hunter Tillman. And once again, the Chargers have the leading lady aboard. Here comes Upton. Jay's batting .136 on the season. He squares and bunts, and that's fouled. Count goes to 0-1.
We got 2-2, here you go.
This is only the fourth start for Upton this season. The 0-1. Here it comes. He's swinging and waved at and missed for 0-2.
Head in, 2-2, here you go. All way, babe.
Two runs, two hits, no errors for the Warhawks. Two runs, two hits, and no errors for the Chargers. Snap throw to first, sliding back safely. There's Tillman. Tillman has snagged six bases on the year, only been caught once. The 0-2, snap throw again, as that just does get past the first baseman, not far enough away for any runner advancement. wind continues to blow out more towards center field straight away, more towards right center, actually. The 0-2. Just a tad high for ball one.
You go to two movement.
Upton's ready. So is Beach. Another throw to first, and that was closer. Tillman maybe caught leaning a little right there, but it slides back safely. The 1-2. There he goes. And that's fouled away. We're going to have to do it all over again. Count stays at 1-2. Long look at the armband on the left wrist there at Beach. Both pitchers were in some first inning trouble. Snap throw, and that gets away, and that will advance Tillman. And that will keep on trucking out the third for Tillman on that throwing error by Beach. So all of a sudden, once again, a chance for the Chargers to take the lead with a runner on third. They had that opportunity in the first as well. But this go around, nobody out. Upton looking at a one ball, two strike count. Here comes the 1-2. Just stays alive, does Upton.
Would it be on it?
Count continues to hold steady at one ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Waved out and missed for strike three. So one out here in the home half of the second. Hugh Wendell. Wendell is batting 077 on the year. This is his eighth game that he has appeared in. That gets away from the catcher, but squirts loose in front of him. So, no advancement by Tillman. Started off this second inning with an infield hit. Now the wind's starting to shift towards straightaway center field.
RBI, babe.
Throw one up in the jet stream and let it run. The 0-1. High and outside for ball one. Beach is set. The 1-1. Floater in there on the curve, and it found a home behind the plate for strike two. That one had a nice bend on it right there from Beach. The 1-2. Roller to short. That will score the run, but it is out number two. Chargers lead it 3-2. So that'll turn around the lineup, and that'll bring up Merritt Carter. He drew a four-pitch walk in his first at-bat and later scored the first of what is now three runs up on that scoreboard. First pitch to him here is in there for strike one. All of a sudden, Beach going to that curveball here and throwing it pretty accurately. The 0-1. Right back where it came from. Boy, Beach almost giving a haircut right there. A nice hard hit by Carter. Gets him on first for the second consecutive time for him. See if we can't mount ourselves a little two-out rally. Vialta is up next. He was hit by a pitch in his first at bat.
You go eat.
You know, left-handed batter digs in, takes a look at ball one outside. First time Beach has gotten behind a hitter in at least what I have in front of me the last two batters. The 1-0. Launched into right center field, but not enough, as squeezing it there is the right fielder in Franklin. And that'll do it for the Chargers in the second. But a run scores on two hits. There was a costly error for the Warhawks. We're through two. Chargers lead it. 3-2.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
We are through two innings here at Charger Park. Steve Moulton back here with you on Zone 2, as well as on Flow Sports. From, if you want to check out the camera work, you can go to uhchargers.com. It'll be 3, 4, and 5 due up for the Warhawks as we head to the third. Inside for ball one, out of the gate for Connor Edwards. Started this game for the Chargers, continues his work. The 1-0, little tapper foul. Struggled out of the gate, did Connor, as eight different Warhawks had an AB in the top of the first, but calmed down quite nicely. And inning number two, that's as low for ball two. Connor.
Go to it.
Two in the first, one in the second for the Chargers.
Nice.
That's in there for a called strike two. Well-placed ball that time for Connor. That's a little low. Maybe a little miscommunication that time between catcher and pitcher. Looked to me as if Reagan may have been crossed up a little. The 3-2. Tip foul. Count stays at 3-2. I noticed not a whole lot of folks use that parking lot that's closer to the field along the third baseline. A lot of people know. The 3-2, waved at and missed for strike three. That is the first strikeout of the day for Connor Edwards. That'll bring up Thomas.
You go to eight. Play sport.
Thomas with a solid base hit in his first at bat. Stranded at third. Nice ball right there for Edwards as it's in there for strike one. The 0-1. That finds a patch of grass over the first baseman's head, and back-to-back base hits for Thomas. So the Warhawks get a runner on with one out here in the top of the third. Irvis 0 for 1. The lined out to right field in his first at bat. Takes a look at strike one. Healthy lead at first. That's the tying run. That's waved at and miss. Quickly ahead is Connor Edwards, 0-2. To the designated hitter for the Warhawks, the 0-2 tip foul. Count stays at 0-2. The 0-2. That gets away from the Charger catcher and Reagan, and moving forward on that wild pitch is Thomas. Bless you. Nothing wrong with being polite. Wind is starting to really whip out towards straightaway center now. The 1-2 pitch. Hammered down the left field line. That's a base hit. And this will put runners on the corners as the stop sign is thrown up. So runners on the corners with one out. And brings up Seaman. So after a strikeout to start off this third inning, back-to-back hits for the Warhawks. See whether or not we can get a 6-4-3 right here. Here's the pitch. That one launched into right, and that will drop in front of our right fielder, but that will be an RBI base hit for Seaman. We're tied at 3 here at Charger Park here in the top of the third. That will bring up Matthew Del Sol. He walked in his first at bat. Runners on first and second with still just one out. That's waved at and missed. Boy, that's a Blackhawk coming right at us. Right above us here at Charger Park as if Redstone Arsenal is right behind us. The 0-1 outside. Should have coordinated that for the anthem right there. I mean, that's low. Now, that's a flyover. The 1-1 tipped foul. Count goes to 1-2. Of course, a big military presence that we have here in North Alabama. The 1-2. Waved at and missed for strike 3. So two outs now. Both strikeouts via of the swinging K variety. That'll bring up the Warhawk catcher and Greer, who ended the first inning with a fly out to center. Takes a look at ball one outside for Edwards. Edwards is ready. The 1-0. Right in there for strike one. Edwards checks the armband, the 1-1. Here it comes. low and outside for ball two. Two on, two out, top of the third. We're tied at three. The 2-1. Little number and snare by the shortstop that time as the Chargers get out of it by an excellent play by Wendell. And a run scored on three hits, no errors, two left for the Warhawks. We're through two and a half. We're tied at three.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
We're tied at three, home half of the third here at Charger Park. Steve Moulton back here with you. Glad to have you along for the ride on this non-conference conference game. I know, it doesn't make any sense to me either. Three runs, three hits, no errors for the Chargers. Three runs, five hits, one error. And it was a costly one by the pitcher on a throw to first. Back in the second inning, it'll be 3, 4, and 5 due up for the Chargers. As Brock Butler will start things off.
Leading up for the Chargers, the designated hitter, Brock Butler.
Brock Butler had himself a nice double back in the first, a 2 RBI double.
Go for it.
And away we go here in the home half of the third, tied at three. Beach is ready, kicks and fires, and that went right up the elevator shaft off of the deflection from the catcher and Greer. One ball, no strikes. The 1-0. Hammered to center, drifting back and squeezing it right in front of the warning track is the center fielder and Freeman for a noisy out. That'll bring up J.C. Wilburn. Wilburn 0-for-1 with a fly out to center as well. So the wind was really kicking up really through the first 2.5 innings. And as soon as that ball launched into the air, I took a look and that flag was just lying limp on the pole out there right behind center field. I guess timing is everything. First pitch to Wilburn's a strike. Count goes to 0-1. Beach working quickly. The 0-1. That curve lands outside for ball one. Now the flag kicks up again. Goodness gracious. Could have used that about maybe a minute and a half ago. The 1-1. Inside around the wrist. Two balls, one strike to count. Here's the pitch, inside for ball three. Getting some text messages from a couple of our local media. Uh-oh, they're actually paying attention to me this afternoon. It swung on and missed for strike two. Yes, I'll occasionally watch local media now. Olivia and Mo. I got some splaining to do now. As that's inside for ball four. So a one out walk. And a tie game at three. Here in the home half of the third. Jackson Lindsay is 0 for 1 with a K on the day.
Go five.
Here's the pitch. Outside for ball one. Wellburn at first. The 1-0. Waved at and miss for strike one. Let me take a look at Mr. Wilburn there at first. He has yet to attempt a stolen base on the year. The 1-1 foul down the third baseline. Count goes to 1-2.
Nice. Here you go.
The 1-2 pitch. Tapper foul down the first baseline. Count stays at 1-2. Boy, Major League Baseball opening day right around the corner. I think we're about maybe, I know the Braves start on the 28th, which is a week from Thursday. The 1-2 inside. Count goes to 2-2. On the subject of those Bravos, your home for the Braves is right here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone. And also our sister station, Talk Radio WZZN, your new home of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. The 2-2 fouled away. Be good to hear Josh Carey once again. Behind the mic for another season of Trash Pandas baseball. So many years we had the Stars and they decided to go be Shuckers. Went for maybe about a 6-year span of no minor league baseball here in this area. And Madison built a gorgeous facility where Toyota Field, now the center spot of town Madison. The 3-2 right up the gut and a little flip from second to short, and even though the shortstop dropped it, it was after Tunnel stepped on the bag, so fielder's choice for out number two. That'll bring up Reagan. Reagan was the last batter of the first inning.
He go 4-2.
Grounded out to short in his first at-bat. It'll take a two-out rally here as that's fouled away on the first pitch he faces.
Good idea. Here you go.
Lindsay at first. And that hit Reagan. Every once in a while, my coach would tell me to lean into one. It was usually when I was struggling, which was quite a bit, actually. I can still hear Coach Roman at Tucker High School, lean into it. That'll bring up Tillman. Hunter Tillman had an infield hit in his first at-bat. First pitch, waved at and missed for strike one. Two on, two out, tied at three in the home half of the third. Beach is set. The 0-1. Here it comes. Outside for ball one.
You go nine.
54 pitches so far for Beach. The 1-1. Right up the elevator shaft. Who wants it? And diving on that stab is the third baseman, Aaron Del Sol, but that ends the inning there for the Chargers on that pop out to third. No runs, no hits, no errors, two Chargers left. We're through three, we're tied at three between the Warhawks and the Chargers here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
The scoring line, actually the line I should say for Connor Edwards through three innings, is a total of 17 batters faced, 63 pitches. He'll continue out on the hill as that first pitch is outside for ball one. 9-1-2 are due up, just like happened in the second inning. Let's hope we can rinse and repeat there as we went 1-2-3 in the second. That is outside for ball two. Once again, that stiff breeze has decided to go on a vacation. That's in there for strike one for Edwards. Wind appeared to have calmed down a bit. The 2-1, waved that in, miss for strike two. Tunnel 0-for-1, bounced out to the first baseman in a sliding out by the pitcher. That's served to second, on to first in time on the 4-3 put out. One up, one down for the Chargers here in the visiting half of inning number four here at Charger Park. Our audience is growing, evidently. Here's the pitch into left field, or an old Adam ball right into the glove there for Tillman for out number two. So to answer your question, Tom, no, I don't have a show this afternoon. For those of you that know me in this market, do a show with West Neighbors beginning at 5 o'clock every day. I'm magically going to be on the air at 5 o'clock, though, over the airwaves. The magic of radio. In there for strike one, Stash. He is 0-for-1 officially on the day. Walked and scored in his first at-bat. The 0-1. Just missed. Boy, Edwards wanted that one. Count goes to 1-1. Here's the pitch. Launched into center, and that bounces in front of Upton for a two-out base hit. Okay, so now he's asking me why no show. There's this little thing called March Madness going on today, and you'll be able to hear it over the airwaves of 97.7 ESPN The Zone. The first four starts at 5:30. The coverage does Central Time. That just misses low for ball one for Franklin's third at-bat of the afternoon. We're tied at three here in the fourth. The 1-0 will not be made. Instead, throw over to first. Sliding in safely there is the first baseman for the Warhawks. The 1-0. Just miss inside for ball two. Reagan tried to sell that a good bit. And home plate umpire Christian Moffitt was not biting. The 2-0. That hit him inside, and all of a sudden a little two-out trouble. That'll bring up Thomas. Ashton Thomas, a graduate student from Evans, Georgia. Takes a look at low, ball one. See at least one Charger pitcher in the bullpen. Meeting out on the mound. This inning started out with a tapper to second and a line to left. All of a sudden, a little trouble here with a base hit and then a hit by a batsman, or a hit by a pitch. And we'll get another one. So they're loaded now. Base is full of Warhawks.
You go 2-8. One out now. Here we go. That's all we need.
Amen. So, time is called. Coach Hunter Royer on his way out to the mound. And that will do it for Connor Edwards. We'll take a pause here for a pitching change. Tied at three with two outs here in the home half of the fourth.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made that the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Their locations and on the web at sportsmedalabama.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Justin Peralt is your new Charger pitcher, the senior from Homewood High School from Birmingham, Alabama. Checks in for the Chargers, and he's right in the thick of the soup, too, as he'll have bases full of Warhawks. But there are two outs here in the inning. His numbers heading into this one. This is his sixth appearance of the year with an ERA of 10.80. Through five innings, 11 hits, 10 runs, six of them earned. Two walks, a K. He has given up three doubles and two dingers on the year. And opponents are batting .423 against the senior. This inning started out innocently enough with a roller to second, a line out to left, and then a solid base hit by the Warhawks first baseman, then back-to-back hit by pitch has loaded him up. We're tied at three here in the top of the fourth. Peralt is just about done. He is done. That'll bring up Purvis. One for two on the afternoon. A Warhawks designated hitter. Bags full of Warhawks in a tie game. He'll take a look at strike one. Nice ball by Peralt on the hook. Paints the outside corner. Peralt is set. The 0-1. Inside and low. Nice take that time by Purvis. Count goes to 1-1. A Warhawk at every base. We're tied at three, but two outs here in the fourth. The 1-1. That's a knee buckler right there. Was expecting the express. Got the change up. Count goes to 1-2. Pitch away. Let's see where Peralt goes here. The 1-2. Low and outside, 2-2. Purvis did not go fishing right there. And see if Peralt goes out there one more time. Wind starting to pick up again. Blowing out straightaway center. A 2-2. Launched into right field, backpedaling, and it's still going, and it's over the fence for a grand slam home run for Peralt, or Purvis, rather, excuse me. And just like that, four runs on the board, and it's 7-3, Warhawks. Boy, this has started with two outs here in the fourth inning. Seaman up next. He's 1-2, and he has just been hit by a pitch as well. That is the third Warhawk to be hit by a pitch in this top of the fourth. So that will do it in terms of the line for Connor Edwards. Soul next up. Base hit, an RBI base hit, and a walk back in the first. Warhawks have opened it up here in the fourth. They lead it 7-3 over the Chargers off of a grand slam home run. When Peralt was a pitch away from getting out of the mess, that slips away from the Charger first baseman and Lindsey. Seaman advances to second on the throwing error. Got to have a short attention span out there on the hill. Let's see if Peralt can get out of this without any more damage. And here's the pitch. Foul back to the fence. Two runs in the first, one in the third, four here in the fourth for AUM. And You know, that wind kicking up a little bit. No doubt that that ball that was launched by Purvis may have gotten a little help from the jet stream, but nonetheless, a big knock for Purvis, the designated hitter for the Warhawks. Count goes to 1-1. Del Sol, the 1-1 from Peralt, takes a look at the runner at second. Here it comes. It's in there for strike two. One pitch away. Let's go rattle some bats. The 1-2. And that heads out towards the Bermuda Triangle, but squeezing it anyway is Upton at center field, who came darting in, but a rather productive inning after the first two outs of inning number four. Four runs cross home plate for the Warhawks, and they lead it 7-3 as we head to the home half of the fourth here at Charger Park on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made at the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by other lawyers.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
To the home half of the fourth we go. New pitcher out on the mound for the Warhawks. That would be Trey Bacon. Trey, a senior from Tampa, Florida. And for Trey, this is his third appearance of the year. Has an ERA of 1.50 through 3 1/3 innings pitched. Two hits, one run, none of them earned. Three walks, four strikeouts. Opponents averaging 182 against Trey. But again, this is only his third appearance of the year, as both starters have now exited stage left. So it's time for a rally. It'll be 8-9-1 due up for the Chargers. Upton is first up for the hit parade. Let's start the merry-go-round, shall we? We're going to need to. We're down by four in the bottom of the fourth. First pitch is low and inside for ball one. Second pitch, high for ball two. Nice crowd on hand here at Charger Park. Free admission. Come on out and enjoy some baseball and softball, as we'll have plenty of it. Three balls and no strikes to Upton out of the gate. And here's the pitch outside, a four-pitch walk right out of the gate. That happened to Carter in the bottom of the first. We scored twice in the first inning. Scored once in the twice in the first, once in the second. And now down by four, 7-3. Coming up this weekend, it will be Montevallo in town. Charger Park will be bustling, weather pending. I think weather should be good this weekend for a single game on Friday and double dipper on Saturday. The 1-0 in the dirt. Count goes to 2-0. So far, a promising start, but honestly, I mean, this is just one of the many twists of baseball as AUM scored four runs, and it was all with two outs in the top of the fourth. The 2-0 gets away. That's a wild pitch, and Upton advances to second. We'll take it. Bacon receives the baseball from Greer. And a quick look at the standings in the Gulf South Conference. Overall, leading the way would be West Florida, the Argonauts, with a conference record of 10-2. Followed by Lee and Montevallo at 8-4. AUM, the squad at 9-6. Then West Georgia Delta State at 7-5. And just north of 500 is Valdosta State at 8-7. Then it's West Alabama and Union at 6-9. Chargers check in at 4-8. The 3-0 and a four-pitch walk yet again. So runners on first and second now here for the Chargers. And here comes the top of the order. Behind the Chargers in the standings, Shorter at 5-10. Also at 4-8 is Mississippi College. And Christian Brothers is 5-10 in conference play as well. Carter awaits the pitch from Bacon. Here it comes. Inside for ball one. Carter had a four-pitch walk that he earned in his first at-bat and later scored in the first inning. I'm okay with loading him up. The 1-0. Inside ball two. Trey Bacon having trouble finding the strike zone. Time is called. Plenty of other games going on today on the diamond. On this Tuesday, March the 19th, 2024, CBU playing host to Lane. Delta State is taking on Trevecca. They will join the Gulf South Conference next year. Columbus State is in Livingston. Take on West Alabama. Mississippi College and Union squaring off in Jackson, Tennessee. Eckerd is in Valdosta to take on the Blazers. The Saints are taking on the Flames. That would be the University of North Georgia taking on Lee. Georgia Southwestern, that'd be the Hurricanes and the Argonauts there in Pensacola, Florida. And later on tonight, it'll be the Spartans and the Wolves. That's in there for strike one from Bacon. So whatever was said out there on the mound immediately pays off for Bacon. As he finds the strike zone, count goes to 2-1. Here's the pitch. Served in the left center. Will this find a spot? And it will. It rolls to the wall. One run is going to score, and that'll do it. A double for Carter draws us to within three. So an RBI double scores Upton. Wendell advances to third. And here comes Carson Vialta with he is the tying run. After giving up a grand slam in the top of the fourth, a chance to do some damage here in the home half as Bacon finding the strike zone yet again in there for strike one near the belt buckle. Peralta flew out to right in his last at bat. The 0-1 outside. Count goes to 1-1. Brock Butler on deck. On the 1-1 inside, count goes to 2-1. Seven runs, seven hits, one error for AUM. Four runs, four hits, one error for the Chargers. Let's tie things up, shall we? The 2-1. Little left center base hit, and that will find a patch of grass. That's going to score two. And Peralta is going to have to halt for a long two RBI single. But now we're a runaway. It is 7-6. Still nobody out here in the fourth. And that might be it. A quick hook for AUM. We'll tell you the pitching change right after this.
You've got to experience Toyotathon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyotathon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey.
Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time. Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
New pitcher out on the hill for the Warhawks is Michael Myers, a graduate student from Coleman, Alabama. Went to Coleman High School. His line on the year, this is his 10th appearance overall with an ERA of 8.25. Through 12 innings pitched, he's given up 18 hits, 13 runs, 11 of them earned, 2 walks, 8 strikeouts. He has not given up, oh, wait a second, he's not given up a triple this year. He has given up 3 home runs on the year, and opposition batting 327 against Mr. Myers. Chargers have come out swinging after being down by 4 runs. And there is still nobody out here in the home half of the fourth. As Butler is at first after a 2 RBI base hit. A short outing. Trey Bacon making way for Michael Myers. Nothing scary about this situation, right? Let's hope not. Here comes Brock Butler. The Chargers designated hitter, and boy, did he hammer one in the first inning. That was a 2 RBI double. He hammers that one. Pulled it way foul down the left field line. Straighten it out there, Brock. Wind now towards right center field. Waved at and missed by Butler. Count goes to 0-2. The 0-2 pitch. Little knuckler to second on the short for one and not in time on the turn. But that is out number one on the fielder's choice. That'll bring up J.C. Wilburn. Officially 0-for-1 on the day with a walk. Tying run is at first as the side armor curls it outside for ball one. I would say a little Kent to Colby action, but all I'm doing is aging myself saying that name. We're 1-0. In there for strike one. Well-placed ball by Myers that time. Called Kent DeColvey the rubber band man back in the day, pitching for the Pirates. The 1-1. That gets by the shortstop. Turning around second, heading for third. Runners on the corners now. With one out here in the fourth. Couldn't have placed that ball any better. That'll bring up Jackson Lindsay. 0-for-2. And this one with a K on the day. Tying run is at third with one out here in the fourth. Two in the first, one in the second so far, three here in the fourth. So far, matching AUM as closely as we can. Chargers did have a 3-2 lead heading into the top of the third, but AUM matched it up and then put a four spot here in the top of the fourth, and so far three have touched home plate for the Chargers here in the home half of the fourth, a 2-0. In there for strike one. Runners on the corners, one out. There's the pitch. In there for strike two. A 2-2 from Myers is low and outside for ball three. A bad one here would load him up. Here's the 3-2. Into center field, an Adam ball, but this may tie us. There's the sack fly, and we are tied at 7 here in the fourth. So again, matching AUM, almost inning for inning. That'll bring up Reagan. Oh, for one on the day as he finds that one. A little seam right up the heart of the diamond. He may have hit that one off of his thumbs. Nonetheless, it turns into a blazing base hit. So, 7 runs on 7 hits and 1 error at each aside. AUM, 7 runs, 7 hits, 1 error. Likewise for the Chargers, but a chance for the Chargers to retake the lead here with 2 outs in the fourth as that's in there for strike one. Hunter Tillman, 1-for-2 on the day. The 0-1. That rolls to second, gobbled up, and that'll do it for the Chargers here in the fourth, but able to climb back into this one. 7 runs, 7 hits, and 1 error aside after 4 innings of play. I'll turn into Chris Stewart. Let's start over. How about that? We'll be right back.
Tom Abraham here from my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's NorthAlabamaMortgage.com.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration, we show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Off to the fifth we go. Tied at seven. New pitcher on the mound for the Chargers here this Tuesday afternoon, Logan Mooney, freshman from Athens, Alabama. Went to Athens High School. For Mooney, this is his eighth appearance of the year with an ERA of 5.11 through 12 and a third innings pitched. 13 hits, 9 runs, 7 of them earned. He's walked 11, struck out 11, has given up one double on the year, has yet to allow either a triple or a homer, and the opposition is batting 255 against him. Let's see whether or not we can put up a zero like we did in the second inning, which was our, is that our only one, two, that is our only one, two, three innings so far, was the top of the second for AUM. 8-9-1 due up, as that's fisted foul by Greer. But AUM really showed that all three outs, vitally important. They scored four times with two outs the last time they rattled the bats, and Greer gets hit by a pitch. That is one, two, three, four hit by pitches by Charger pitching. Here comes Tunnel, 0 for 2 on the day. The left-hander set the pitch. And that gets away from the Charger catcher, and advancing is Greer on the wild pitch. And the Warhawks are in business yet again here in the top of the fifth. Let's see whether or not we can steady the ship, as that's a nice high express right there. And Tunnel swings and misses for strike one. The 1-1 outside for ball two. Just a beautiful day. A little chilly. Supposed to warm up, though, tomorrow. The 2-1. Here it comes. Right down the heart of the plate for strike two. Mooney set. 2-2. Here it comes. Inside for ball three. Supposed to warm up to 70 tomorrow, but I don't like what I'm seeing for Friday. An 89% chance of rain on Friday. We shall see. The 3-2. Little roller to second, and everybody's going to be safe. E4 on that play. So runners on the corners with nobody out here in the fifth. Tied at 7. Here comes Freeman. Maybe one of the hardest hit balls was the first pitch he saw of the afternoon. He'll try to bunt it, and that goes foul. Count goes to 0-1. Officially 1-3 on the day with a run scored as well. Go-ahead run is at third with nobody out here in the fifth. Here's the 0-1. Down the first baseline. Nice stab there defensively. A diving catch by the Charger first baseman. And Jackson Lindsay for out number one. So that'll bring up the Warhawks first baseman. Scratching. He is 1-for-2 on the day. With 2 runs scored, he has walked as well. Throw to first. Back in time. 1 out here in the top of the fifth. Mooney is set. The left-hander again fires off to first. Everybody's safe. Runners on the corners. We've had a hit-by-pitch, a wild pitch, an error, and a little pop out to first.
Nice.
Just a tad outside for ball one. The Warhawks first baseman. He is the two-hole hitter. The 1-0. Floats it in there for strike one. Freshman getting some work here on a Tuesday afternoon. Charger Park. The 1-1. Right in there for strike two. The 1-2 will not be made. Again, throw over to first. Everybody's safe. That's launched foul down the first baseline, rather. And out of play. The third pitcher of the day for the Chargers is Logan Mooney. The 1-2. Put a charge into it. Squeezed by the left fielder. Here comes the sack fly. Throw onto home. Not in time. The Warhawks lead it 8-7. So a sack fly RBI there. Two outs here in the fifth. That'll bring up Franklin. Franklin officially 1-for-2 on the day with an RBI as well as a strikeout. High and inside, just under the chin. Count goes to 1-0. Already the fourth time through this lineup here for the Warhawks. They've scored 8 times. They lead it by 1. That hits off the mound. A nice backhanded stab 4-3 on that put out, and that'll do it for the Warhawks here in the fifth. But a run scores on no hits, no error, or one error, and one left. We're through 4.5, 8-7 AUM here at Charger Park. Here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and, of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Eight to seven, the score in favor of AUM. So, I mean, if we're going to follow the script here, we're almost doing it. Each team has scored two in the first. Then the Chargers scored one in the second. AUM countered with one in the third. Neither team scored at least in one half inning. Each team put up a four spot in the fourth. A single run for the Warhawks in the top of the fifth, albeit unearned. So this means we're going to score a run here in the home half of the fifth, right? We shall see. The 0-1 into center field and squeezed. That time by the Warhawks center fielder. And Freeman, one up, one down for the Chargers here in the fifth. And that'll bring up Wendell. 8-9-1 officially due up, but of course Upton is out, and that'll bring up Wendell. He scored his last time up, after earning a walk. He starts off this at bat with a ball inside. The 1-0. Shot, tomahawk chop right there to short on to first in time. Two up, two down for the Chargers here in the fifth. Let's see if Merrick Carter can rattle the bats here and start a little two-out trouble.
Here go one.
Merrick had a solid double in his last at-bat, an RBI double. Sophomore out of Shelbyville, Tennessee. That's a foot outside for ball one. By Michael Myers, who continues his time out on the mound for the Warhawks. He is the third pitcher as well for AUM. The 1-1. Low and outside for ball two.
You go one.
8-7-1 for AUM, 7-7-2 for UAH. The 2-1 inside for ball three. Hand it over to Carson. Let's hand the baton off. The 3-1, here it comes. Into center field, and with a beat on it yet again is Freeman. That'll do it for the Chargers here in the fifth. So No script followed there. In fact, that's the first 1-2-3 inning of this game for AUM. They lead it by one as we head to the sixth.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Steve Moulton back here with you, live from Charger Park. It is a one-run game. AUM leading it 8-7 as we head to the sixth. Chargers 9-2 here at home this season. Looking to get into double digits in the win total here this afternoon. But it'll be 4, 5, and 6 due up for AUM, beginning with Mr. Thomas as he digs in. That is in there for strike one from Mooney out on the mound. The 0-1 just misses outside for ball one. Mentioned the homestand this weekend for the Chargers against Montevallo earlier, and they'll be at home for a minute here as the 1-1 is outside for ball two. Chargers back at home coming up on the 26th. In fact, you could make a full baseball day out of it if you'd like, as that's fouled back by Thomas. Count goes to 2-2.
Go 3-7.
The Chargers take on Tuskegee at 2 o'clock. Well, later on that night, Alabama baseball will be over at Toyota Field as they'll take on Belmont that same Tuesday night, a week from today. The 2-2 waved at and missed for strike three. Then the Chargers continue their homestand against the Lee Flames, the 29th and the 30th. And then they'll continue to be at home on April the 2nd, taking on Miles. That's going to do it for Mooney. And we'll tell you about the new Charger pitcher right after this.
Tom Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's North Alabama Mortgage.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Cole Loftus is next up for the Chargers on the mound. Our fourth pitcher of the afternoon. Went from Edwards to Peralt to Mooney, now Loftus. Sophomore out of Hayden, Alabama. Cole's numbers on the year. This is his seventh overall appearance with an ERA of 8.62 through 15 and two-thirds innings pitched. He's given up 21 hits, 17 runs. 15 of those 17 have been earned. Nine walks, 14 strikeouts. He has given up one long ball. Opponents are batting 313 against Cole this season. Trying to keep AUM put as they lead it 8-7 here in the sixth. One out here after the strikeout by Mooney to finish out his work out there on the mound. In fact, if I can bring it up and multitask here. Mooney went an inning and a third. First pitch to Purvis is outside for ball one. Purvis announced his presence the last time he was up there and launches that one foul. Count goes to 1-1. A grand slam home run for Mr. 34 the last time he dug in. Well, he can't do that this time. Nobody on base here for the Warhawks. Count goes to 1-1. Here's the pitch. Outside for ball two. That's fouled and out of play. Purvis is 2-for-3 with a run scored, 4 runs driven in off of that grand slam the last time he was up. The 2-2, here it comes. Gets away from the Charger catcher, but no harm there as it's low. Or was that tap foul? No, it is low for ball three.
He go for five.
Cole Office kicks and fires on a full count. That is out of play, will stay in play and foul ground. Just does land right in front of the Charger dugout. Turns into a noisy strike and stays full at 3-2. Started off this inning with a strikeout. See if we can get back-to-back Ks here at Charger Park. The 3-2 pitch. Fouled away. Staying alive is the designated hitter for the Warhawks. Matt. Is way up there, stays on the infield and squeezed by the Charger first baseman and Jackson Lindsay for out number two. And I'll bring up Seaman. And here's the pitch. And there for strike one. Seaman from Montgomery, Alabama. The 0-1. High and inside for ball one. The 1-1. Fouled away quickly ahead. Goes Cole Office. Strike away from seeing if we can't tie things up. The 1-2. Little nubber down the third baseline. Scooped up onto first in time. Beautiful play by the Charger third baseman and Carson Vialta. And that'll do it for the Warhawks in the sixth. No runs, no hits, no errors. No Warhawks left. 8-7 AUM, leading it by a run here at UIH through 5.5.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Back here at Charger Park. Certain things don't need to be on the air anyway. 8-7 the score. AUM leading it here at UAH. Chargers looking to tie things up. Held the lead briefly earlier. After two innings, we were up 3-2. Then we've just been kind of seesawing back and forth a bit where they score four, we score four. They score one, well, we have yet to score one. Hence the one-run lead for AUM as we head to the sixth, as Vialta launches that foul to start the home half of the sixth. Myers continues his work. The 0-1 inside for ball one.
You go 1-3.
The 1-1. Outside, 2-1. Mentioned the long homestand here for the Chargers. This is a real opportunity, frankly, for both the baseball and softball teams to build up some momentum here down the stretch of the regular season. Little number to second. Nice job of the second baseman to keep it in front of him, Seaman, but nonetheless, that's an infield hit, I think. Yeah. Just clarifying. Start things off for the Chargers here in the sixth with the tying run on first base. Brock Butler. Officially 1-for-3 on the day. 2 RBI day for Mr. Butler. How about doubling it up? He tried to off the first swing, but that's foul. Back to the fence. Count goes to 0-1.
He go four.
The 0-1 will not be made. Throw to first, not in time. The 0-1. Outside for ball one. The alt at first. The 1-1. Hit foul. Count goes to 1-2. Boy, Brock is hacking. He wants to hit the ball real hard. Let's see if he can do it. The 1-2. He does, and it finds a hole. That's a base hit. Vialta will stop at second. First two Chargers find themselves on the base paths here in the home half of the sixth.
That'll
bring up J.C. Wilburn. Wilburn 1-for-2 on the day with a walk as well. He has yet to score a run or drive in a run. We can change that right here. JC squares to bunt and bunts it foul. There are nobody out here in the sixth inning. So the next time the Chargers are on the road is on April the 5th in Carrollton. The 0-1. Fouled away. Count goes to 0-2. So come on out here to Charger Park. Free admission to Charger Park for both softball and baseball. Nice long homestand, and the good news is in spring going to launch here tonight, and the warmer weather will follow. The 0-2 outside for ball one. The line for Myers so far after the 1-2.
Good job.
Fouled away. Count stays at 1-2. So far through 10 batters faced. Two full innings pitched now from Michael Myers. Has thrown 32 pitches and has yet to give up a run. The 1-2 just missed outside. Count goes to 2-2. First two Chargers have reached base here in the sixth.
You go 1-7. RBI, babe.
Here's the 2-2 to JC. Topper down the third baseline, steps on third, on to first, double play. Wow, what a play by DeSol at third. Or was that a double play? Yes, it was a double play. So double play, 5-3 on the put out. Wow. That hurts, because now that puts two outs here in the inning for Jackson Lindsay. That's the bad news. The good news is that that did advance Butler to second, so a runner in scoring position, but it'll take some two-out trouble.
Here go five. Get him in, baby.
Put a charge into one, and we can lead it by one. The 1-0 to Lindsay. In there for strike one. He didn't like it. Wynn now whipping out to straightaway center. The 1-1, a foot outside for ball two. Myers is set, the 2-1. In there for strike two on the outside edge. Wynn continuing to kick up.
Nobody.
Tying run is at second. The 2-2 pitch, here it comes. Bouncer to second, gobbled up on first. In time, the Warhawks escape some trouble via their bullpen. And Mike Myers has come in and shut things down. As we head to the seventh, it's a one-run lead for the Warhawks, 8-7. Here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Bill Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Bill Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Bill Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Bill Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at BillPennyToyota.com. Bill Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey. Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time. Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Off to the top of the seventh we go. Neither team scored in the sixth, although the Chargers threatened right out of the gate, but a nice defensive play by the third baseman for the Warhawks. And looky who starts off the seventh inning. That would be DeSoul. He is officially 0 for 2 on the day as that goes into right center field, and it will find a soft spot and roll to the wall. How many bags is he going to take? It'll be a leadoff double for Soul for the Warhawks to start off the visiting seventh. So that'll bring up Greer. He is oh for two. Did reach on an error. That's high and inside for ball one. Loftus continues his work. Can see someone else trying to get warm down the Charger bullpen. The 1-0. Floater low for ball two. 8-8-1 for the Warhawks, 7-9-2 for the Chargers. 2-0. Foul back to the fence. Count goes to 2-1. Good opportunity here for the Chargers to build up some momentum here. Front of a long homestand, the 2-1 foul to back. Count goes to 2-2. Chargers 9-2 here on our home field. 9 of our 15 wins have occurred right here at Charger Park. The 2-2 into center field. Upton will squeeze it. Had a nice beat on it right off of the crack of the bat for out number one. That'll bring up Tunnel. He's 0 for 3. Swung on and miss. Threw that one so hard and took his lid off. The 0-1 gets away. Wild pitch will advance the runner to third. So a little insurance is standing at third with one out here in the seventh. And so hopefully we can keep him there. The infield comes in right on the edge of the dirt and the grass. And what is a one-run lead for the Warhawks right now? The 1-1. Loftus needs a new lid, evidently. Second time he's lost his hat after he throws the pitch. Count goes to 1-2, 1 out here in the top of the seventh. Here's the 1-2 to Tunnel. High for ball two. Lid stayed put that time.
You go, Cole.
The 2-2. Inside for ball three. Hit the bat. thought there was some kind of contact, but we play on. The 3-2. Swung on and missed for strike three. So that'll bring up the top of the order here for the Warhawks. Already earlier in this game, Warhawks, we know, are certainly capable of two-out trouble. First pitch to Freeman. Just missed for ball one. This is at bat number five, is it? It is number five for Freeman. He's got two balls and no strikes on him with two outs. And a chance for the Chargers to wiggle out of some trouble here with a runner on third. The 2-0. Outside ball three. Cole kicks and fires. That's down the heart of the plate right there for strike one. The fourth Charger pitcher of the afternoon is Cole Office. The 3-1. Waved at and missed for strike two. Now the Chargers are one strike away of getting out of this mess. Warhawks looking for insurance right here, the 3-2. Pop foul away, and we'll do it again. Solid third. Here's the 3-2. Fouled away again. Can someone get Cole a new hat? That's at least three or four times as soon as he throws it. He's just putting, I guess, so much momentum on it that lid just didn't want to stay on that head. The 3-2. Again, the lid goes off, but more importantly, it's ball four. High and inside, so runners on the corners. Scratching will come up for his at-bat here with two outs here in the seventh, and what is a one-run lead at the moment for the Warhawks. Can we keep them there? First pitch to Scratching. Is outside for ball one. Let's see, one other pitcher starting to get loose, although still wearing the pullover on a chilly afternoon and evening here in Huntsville, Alabama. The 1-0. That gets away. Here comes some insurance, and it is now 9-7 on that wild pitch by Cole. And Sol scores on that wild pitch. In fact, that's the second time he advanced on a wild pitch. So 9-7 your score now in favor of AUM. Another two-out run for AUM. The 2-0. Tip foul. Count goes to 2-1. It's at least five runs with two outs for AUM here this afternoon. Five of their nine. The 2-1. Inside for ball three. And here we go again with two out trouble. Come on now, just takes one. Offense is set. The 3-1 pitch as he kicks and fires, and that's a full count as that ball is fouled away off to my right. 3-2 the count. To the Warhawks first baseman. The 3-2. Inside ball four. So back-to-back walks for AUM. And once again, another inning in which the Chargers are having trouble getting that third out. Here comes the hook. And we'll tell you about the new Charger pitcher right after this timeout.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right, even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
New Charger pitcher is Trey Wright, the senior from right here in Huntsville, Alabama. Trey on the season. This is his ninth appearance of the year with an ERA of 8.22 through 7 2/3 innings pitched. 6 hits, 8 runs, 7 of the 8 have been earned. 10 walks, 5 strikeouts. He has given up 2 doubles, no home runs on the year. And opponents are batting .207 against Trey as he tries to apply the tourniquet right here as another run has crossed home plate off of a wild pitch. But another 2-out run for AUM. They started a rally in the fourth inning with 2 outs. And here in this seventh inning, they did start out with a double by the Warhawks third baseman, who did later score. But then a fly out to center, a strikeout, then back-to-back walks. Brings up Franklin, the right fielder for the Warhawks. Let's see what Trey can do here. He is set. And did they call a balk? They sure did. So that advances the runners to now 2 in scoring position. Runners on 2nd and 3rd after the balk. Here's the pitch. A little low, I guess, for ball one. Trey wanted that. See if we can't get out of what is a giant mess right here. That's low for ball two. AUM, the big opportunity here to stretching it open. A 2-0. And that rolls in between 2nd and 1st for 1. And here comes the throw at home and not in time. A 2-RBI base hit for Franklin has opened it up for AUM. They now lead it 11-7. That'll bring up Thomas. So a three spot here in the seventh. And again, with two outs, rolls to third, gobbled up on to first in time. No more damage, but there was plenty of damage off of two Warhawk hits. Three AUM players score. They now lead it 11-7 as we head to the home half of the seventh here this Tuesday afternoon.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Phil Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Phil Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Phil Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Phil Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at philpennytoyota.com. Phil Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey. Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time. Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Seventh inning stretch time as we wind it down here. Although work to be done here for the Chargers as they trail at 11-7. Steve Moulton back here with you. A new pitcher for AUM is A.J. Crocker, a junior from Scottsboro, Alabama. A.J. on his season, this is his sixth appearance, has an ERA of 18 through four innings pitched, four hits, eight runs, all of them earned, eight walks, two strikeouts. Opponents are batting 286 against A.J. Let's see if we can't mount a rally here. Did it earlier. We were down by four earlier in this game in the fourth and put up a four spot. Ian Reagan, it's 6-7-8 due up here for the Chargers in the seventh. Here's the pitch. In there for strike one. Just a beautiful day. Ball one. Outside for ball one. The 1-1. Fisted towards center, and Freeman's got a beat on it for out number one. That'll bring up Hunter Tillman. Tillman, 1-for-3 on the day. A lot of ducks on the pond have been left, despite the fact that a total of 18 runs have been scored in this game. AUM has left eight runners on base. The Chargers have left seven runners on base. The 1-0. That's rolled foul down the first baseline. Count goes to 1-1. The deficit is four. Here's the 1-1. Gets away from the Warhawk catcher, Greer. Count goes to 2-1. The 2-1. High for ball three. I'd take a walk right here. The 3-1 hit towards right. Shielding it with that sun is the right fielder. Franklin squeezes it for out number two. That'll bring up Jace Upton. Upton. 0 for 2 officially with a run scored and a walk. Did strike out earlier in the day as well in his first AB and takes a look at strike one. The 0-1. A roller to short on first. And no, not in time. An infield hit. Nice job by Jace to lay it out. And that was kind of a high chopper right there. And that'll bring up Wendell. And here's the first pitch to him outside for ball one. Wendell looking for his first RBI of the year. Let's go for it right here. First home run. Let's be greedy. Two balls, no strikes, the count. On the Chargers shortstop. Quick throw to first. Sliding back safely there is Upton. Able to leg out an infield hit. The 10th hit of the afternoon for the Chargers. The 2-0 in the dirt. It makes it 3-0. Well, a walk here would bring up the top of the order. Maybe a little two-out magic of our own. The 3-0 right down Broadway for strike one. If somehow Wendell can get on, Carter would be next. 3-1. High and inside. Two on, two out. Here comes the top of the order. And all of a sudden, you're a long one away from making this a one-run game. Carter's double may have been the hardest hit ball for the Chargers here so far this afternoon. First pitch is low for ball one. Vialta would be next. Here's the 1-0. Fouled away. Count goes to 1-1. The 1-1 pitch to the Charger leadoff. Batter gets away. Runners advance to second and third. So base hit here would be big. A 2-1. Inside, ball three. Tying run is on deck. Here's the pitch. launched into left center and squeezed, and that'll do it for the Chargers in the seventh. No runs, a hit, no errors, two more Chargers left. We head to the eighth, 11-7, AUM leading it here at Charger Park.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made at the quality of legal services to performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Their locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
97.7 ESPN. And the zone.
On to the eighth we go here at Charger Park. Steve Moulton back here with you. It is a 11-7 lead as 5, 6, and 7 are due up here for AUM. They're leading it in the eighth. First pitch of inning number 8 is called a strike. Unable to hold up was Purvis, but and a grand slam back in the fourth. The 0-1 outside for ball one. Field shifted a bit towards left center. The 1-1. Drilled foul down the third baseline. Count goes to 1-2. And rolls just wide for ball two. Right is set, the 2-2. Ball three. That looked really good there, Mr. Home Plate. The 3-2. That's a tad inside, and it was for ball four. Purvis marches his way down to first for a leadoff walk. I'll bring up Seaman. Warhawks looking for some more insurance. There's nobody out here in the eighth. Little curve in there. Nice pitch that time by Wright. Get ahead in the count, 0-1. Purvis with a lead at first. The 0-1 pitch. Here it comes from Trey. That hit him. So, first two runners. First two batters become runners. Here comes Soule. He had a solid double earlier in this one as well. He's also been hit by a pitch as well. First pitch to him, squaring to bunt. Sacrifice here, done beautifully. And Wright doesn't have a play, no cover at first. Wow. So now bases full of Warhawks. Now both the Warhawks and the Chargers, each with 10 hits apiece. Time called. A walk, a hit by pitch, and infield hit. .11 for .34 is what I heard. So Wright is checking in for Purvis at third. Pinch runner. One ball, no strikes, nobody out here in the eighth. The 1-0. Nice job to keep it in front of it by Ian Reagan. And it certainly prevented a run. Count goes to 2-0. More stirring in the bullpen for the Chargers. The 2-0. Here it comes. Outside 3-0. A bad one here. Walks one in. The 3-0, right down the heart of the plate for strike one. First and third are playing inside the bag. Second and short, playing for a double play. The 3-1, low ball four, and that walks in a run. The merry-go-round begins. And still nobody out here for the Warhawks. It's now 12-7 AUM. And a pitching change is coming for Hunter Royer. We'll step aside and be back here from Charger Park as AUM now enjoys their largest lead of the afternoon, leading it 12-7.
Hey there, UAH fans. I'm Morris Lilienthal. If you've been injured in an accident, visit MorrisTheAttorney.com right now to get the help you need. Don't let the insurance company take advantage of you. I have personally helped over 4,000 clients with their injury claims, and I'm ready to help you too. My firm, Martinson & Beeson, has been helping clients for over 80 years, and we have received over 300 five-star Google reviews. Get in touch with me right now by visiting MorrisTheAttorney.com. There's no charge for our meeting. Again, that's MorrisTheAttorney.com. Look forward to helping you. Go Chargers.
No representation is made at the quality of legal services to be performed is greater than the quality of legal services performed by the lawyer.
SportsMed is the official team physicians of the Rocket City Trash Pandas. And if the pros trust SportsMed, you can too. SportsMed provides every service you might need for complete orthopedic care, specializing in orthopedic surgery, sports medicine, joint replacement, spine surgery, neurosurgery, and podiatry. And they offer their own brace shop, in-house full-body MRI, physical therapy, walk-in clinic, and so much more. Four locations and on the web at SportsMedAlabama.com.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
Tanner Giles set up to be the next Charger pitcher. Redshirt senior from Northport, Alabama. Tanner on the season. This is his ninth appearance. Excuse me, his 12th appearance with an ERA of 2.25. Through 12 innings pitched, 12 hits, 4 runs, 3 of them earned, 4 walks, 3 strikeouts. He has given up 3 long ones, and the opposition batting .250 against him. He'll inherit a mess with the Warhawks already plating a run here in the 8th off of a walk, a hit by a pitch, an infield hit, and another walk. We were playing a game of seesaw here pretty good through the first 4 innings. But since then, a run for AUM in the 5th, 3 in the 7th, and so far 1 here in the 8th has opened it up to a 12-7 advantage. This game was tied at 7. And And here's the pitch outside for ball one. Tunnel, the nine-hole hitter for AUM. He's got Warhawks at every base in front of him. The one out. Outside, two and out. The field is shifted back to play more straight away. The 2-0. Outside, three and out. See if we can find the strike zone here. Come on now, 3-0. Inside for ball four, four-pitch walk. Continues the merry-go-round. Another run plated. And the Warhawks continue to grow the lead. It's now 13-7. That'll bring up Freeman in the top of the order. That's in there for strike one. The 0-1. We'll number back to the mound, on to home for one, and that'll do it. Fielder's choice there. Freeman will take first. Merry-go-round halted temporarily. But with an out here, 1-2 on that put out. Scratching back in the batter's box, takes a look at strike one. Tanner is starting to find a little bit of a rhythm out there on the mound. The 0-1. Drilled into left field. One will score definitely, and that will do it. But a base hit there for the Warhawks is an RBI base hit. Franklin is due up. I don't want to ask, but I feel like I need to ask. Run rule? Is there a run rule? Okay. Well, first pitch to Franklin is in there for strike one. This is a non-conference conference game. The 0-1 fouled away. Count goes to 0-2. Some things just don't make sense to me, including non-conference conference games. But there's a lot that I don't know about, evidently. The 0-2, low and outside for ball one. I could say multiple things, but I'm just going to keep it to myself. The 1-2. Down the left field line, hooking foul. Matt Wilson knows what I'm talking about. The 1-2. In there for a called strike three. That is a big second out there. That is the first looking K of the day. That'll bring up Thomas. Bags are still full of Warhawks. They lead it by seven. Here in the eighth, a three spot here in the eighth after they put three on in the seventh. First pitch to Thomas is in there for strike one. Thomas on the day, a two-hit day. That's fouled away. He's in the hold. Count goes to 0-2. Franklin with a 3-RBI day. Purvis with a 4-RBI day. That's swung on and missed for Thomas, and that'll do it. Back-to-back Ks for the Chargers. Time for a rally, down by 7. It's 14-7. Who says we don't have football here at UAH? We'll be right back.
I'm Abraham here for my friend Brian Hammaker and his team at North Alabama Mortgage. Look, buying a home is the biggest purchase you will make in your life, and it can be a bit intimidating, so you want people that can help walk you through the mortgage process and get you the best deal possible. That's what North Alabama Mortgage does, and they do it in Alabama, Tennessee, and Florida, from first-time purchases to refis, conventional, VA, FHA, and USDA loans. They have the solution at North Alabama Mortgage. Visit NorthAlabamaMortgage.com to learn more. That's North Alabama Mortgage.
Normally, when you call a roofing company, all you hear is, you need a new roof. Not when you call Fleming Roofing and Restoration. Since 1965, the folks at Fleming have been focused on what you need, whether it's an easy repair or a full roof replacement, commercial or residential. And when it comes to storm damage, you want Fleming on your side. They know all the ins and outs of insurance claims and will guide you through the entire process. Log on FlemingHSV.com and book your free estimate today. Fleming Roofing and Restoration. We show up.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
It's a touchdown lead for AUM as we head to the home half of the eighth here on 97.7 ESPN, The Zone, as well as Flow Sports. Glad to have you along on a Tuesday. And here we go with the first batter. Here, Joey Caruso, pinch hitting. Here's the 0-1, fouled away. See if I can't get you some numbers on Joey. Officially 0-2 on the year for Joey. It's outside. For ball one. Freshman from Colliersville, Tennessee takes a look at ball two outside.
You go 3-6.
Cronker continues his work out on the mound. The Scottsboro native kicks and fires, and it's high for ball three. I'd be good with a leadoff walk here. And a freshman awaits the 3-2 pitch. Here it comes. Into left center. There's his first collegiate hit. Atta baby. It's a leadoff base hit for the Chargers. And Bader is next up. Some numbers here on Colin as he takes a look at strike one. And this is his 13th appearance of the year, batting .333. Through 18 at-bats, he has 6 hits. The 0-1 right down the heart of the plate for strike two. AJ in a little bit of a rhythm out there on the mound for AUM. Runner on first, nobody out here in the eighth. The 0-2 is high for ball one. Chargers were down to our final 6 outs, down by 7. The 1-2. Outside 2-2. Wind's starting to die down a little as the sun's setting off to our west. The 2-2. Tad low, count runs full. Here's the 3-2. Called strike three. Now here for the Chargers is Presley Walker.
Pitch hitting for the Chargers, number 24, Presley Walker.
Walker, this is his 17th appearance of the year in games. Through 32 at-bats, total of 8 hits, including 3 doubles on the year tier as well for Presley. And 250 on the year. Junior from Gardendale, Alabama. Launches it down the left field line. And that'll be a home run. So Presley put the charge into one here at Charger Park. Cuts the deficit down and in what is his first home run of the year. So it's 14-9. Just one out. Ramey Harrison continues the pinch hit parade for Hunter Royer. That's fouled away. Harrison batting 311 on the year. Through 74 at-bats, 23 hits, including a home run. 2-1 the count. Rockers set. The 2-1. In there for called strike two. Wind kicking up a tick towards center. The 2-2. Fouled away. Count stays at 2-2. First runs scored by the Chargers off of that two-run dinger since the fourth. That's in the dirt from Crocker. Two in the first, one in the second, four in the fourth, and now two here in the eighth. But the deficit is 5. The 3-2. Chopped over the mound. Tough play for either the shortstop or the second baseman. Not going to happen. An infield hit there for the Chargers. Continues to hand the baton off as now it's Hunter Nolan's turn to pinch hit. My scorecard's a mess. I don't know about you down there. Just off of this one half inning. I mean, I get it from Hunter Royer's perspective of just putting in guys for maybe some different energy, and it's obviously paid off with a two-run home run. But this half inning in particular, yeah, all I know is it's 14-9 with one out here in the bottom of the eighth. Meeting out on the mound. Maybe something to the effect. Oh, they are going with a pitching change. So we'll go through that pitching change right after this timeout.
You've got to experience Toyota-thon at Phil Penny Toyota. They've got the selection with over 700 new Toyotas to choose from. And they've got the extras with Phil Penny perks and a 10-year unlimited warranty. So get on over to Phil Penny Toyota today and experience Toyota-thon. Phil Penny Toyota in Huntsville and online at philpennytoyota.com. Phil Penny's Toyota 10-year unlimited warranty is valid through the 10th year of ownership. Valid on new vehicles only. See dealer for details.
Wake up and text. Text and eat. Text and meet up with a friend you haven't seen in forever.
Hi.
Oh, hey. Text and complain that they're on their phone the whole time. Text and listen to them complain that you're on your phone the whole time. Text and whatever. But when you get behind the wheel, give your phone to a passenger. Put it in the glove box. Just don't text and drive. Visit StopTextsStopWrecks.org. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
New pitcher on the mound for the Warhawks is freshman Cody Lee from Fayetteville, Georgia. Went to Landmark Christian School there in Fayetteville. This is his eighth appearance of the year with an ERA of 10.38. 0-2 on the year. Threw 8 2/3 innings pitched, 11 hits, 14 runs. 10 of those 14 have been earned runs. He's walked 9, struck out 7. He has allowed a home run, and the opposition is batting .314 against him. The pinch hit parade will continue here for the Chargers in the eighth. Came into this last half of the eighth down by 7. Cut it down by 2 after a home run by Presley Walker over the left field wall. Ready to play some ball. Christian Moffitt, home plate umpire, walks behind the AUM catcher and Greer. Runner on first, one out here in the eighth. Here's the pitch. Low for ball one. Cross Capio is on deck. I'm a batter ahead of myself. Hunter Nolan with a 2-0 count in front of him. Fisted foul. Count goes to 1-2.
Here we go, 3-8. Here we go. Good cut.
Nolan looking for his first knock of the year.
Nice, nice.
Low and inside for ball three. Chargers did battle back initially down by 4 in the bottom of the fourth.
Here go, 3-8.
Now down by 5 right here, 14-9. The 3-1 pitch to Nolan. Here it comes. Fouled away. Count runs full at 3-2.
Here go, 3-8.
Long look at the wristband, the 3-2 pitch. Here it comes. Inside, ball four. So, the pinch hit parade continues. Cross Capiano. Cachopio. Dadgummit, Cachopio. And sophomore will dig in. Here's the pitch to Cachopia. Swings and misses for strike one. He's looking for his first hit of the year. Knee buckler right there for strike two. This is his first at bat of the year. The 0-2. Low and outside for ball one. Cross, a sophomore from Jasper, Alabama. Wonder if he was a Viking. The 1-2. Outside, 2-2. Two on, one out, home half of the eighth. We've already scored two. The 2-2 in there for strike three. That's out number two of this eighth inning, and that will bring up Upton. That was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 consecutive pinch hitters. Upton takes a look at ball one. If you really want to mess up a scorebook, that's the first time I've ever seen that many pinch hitters in a row. The 1-0 swung on and missed for strike one. Glad you guys know what you're doing down there, because my scorebook's a mess. That bounces in front of the plate. There to Upton. Count goes to 2-1. Lee again, a look at the wristband on his left wrist. He is set. The 2-1. That eats up the third baseman, and he'll tag the runner right in front of him, the third out of the inning, for the 5 unassisted putout. That'll do it for the Chargers in the eighth. They do score 2 on a 2-run home run by Presley Walker. We head to the ninth. The deficit is 5. 14-9 AUM here at Charger Park.
Eagle Masonry and Insulation. It's right there in the name. Eagle is your one-stop shop for block, stone, or brickwork, monument signs, and outdoor kitchens and fireplaces. Eagle also offers the finest craftsmanship and insulation, including fiberglass or spray foam insulation, and of course, insulation removal. Philip Love and his team have years of experience bringing the region the best in masonry and insulation services. For more information and a quote, visit insulatewitheagle.com or call 256-755-1556. Eagle saves you time. Eagle saves you money.
I'm with Thomas here from Talent Heating and Air. Thomas, you guys are a premier North Alabama locally owned heating and air company.
We pride ourselves in being deep in the community, helping customers with solutions that they can use to keep their house comfortable. We provide emergency services. You can reach us on our website at talenthvac.com, or you can call us at 256-503-4490.
Talent Heating and Air, let them put their talent to work for you.
AL cert number 21014.
97.7 ESPN, The Zone.
We head to the ninth. New pitcher on the mound, Aubrey Cleghorn. Get his numbers here momentarily. Chargers trailing at 14-9 here in the ninth. .14, 11-1 is the totals for AUM. 14 runs, 11 hits, one error for the Chargers. 9, 13-2, 9 runs, 13 hits, and 2 errors. But how about combined a total of 22 runners left on base? 11 apiece for both AUM and UAH. Aubrey, this is his 7th appearance of the year. with an ERA of 7.20, no win-loss record on the year, through five innings pitched, nine hits, five runs, four of them earned, one walk, no Ks. We can work on that. He has not given up a homer either, and the opponent's averaging 391. And we've got a pinch hitter as well. Purdue is pinch hitting here for AUM. So let the pinch hitting continue. First pitch to Purdue from Clay Orton is in there for strike one. The 0-1 in the dirt for ball one. The 1-1. And there for strike two, could not hold up. Purdue in the hole at 1-2. Fouled away and stays alive. I'm assuming this is his first at-bat of the year. He is not even listed on the AUM website. Swung on and missed for strike three for Brody Purdue. Another pinch hitter? Nope. I'll bring up Seaman. First pitch is in there for strike one. Shadows starting to get a little longer here as we're past 6 p.m. Central Time. The 0-1. Towards center. Squeezing it for out number two. Is that still, yeah, it's still Upton out there. Okay, all right.
How about it? The third baseman, Matthew Del Sol.
Del Sol digs in with two outs here in the ninth. Low and outside for ball one. The right fielder, first baseman, and second baseman. And that is launched into left, and that is gone. Sol puts a charge into it, and boy, that was a no-doubter over the left field wall. For Sol. That is his first home run of the year. And that was a no-doubter, too. Outside for ball one. It's now 15-9 in favor of AUM. The 1-0. Just a touch high to Greer, the Warhawk catcher. The 2-0 inside by the belt buckle. Count goes to 3-0. Here's the 3-0 right down the heart of the plate for strike one right there. The 3-1. He is outside for ball four. Been a tough day pitching-wise for the Chargers, as Nat is now a total of nine walks for the Chargers. Add on to the hit batsmen's as well. Tunnel takes a look at strike one to start off this at bat. Deal one pitch. Just low for 1-1. The 1-1. Little chopper foul down the third baseline. Count goes to 1-2. Two outs here in the top of the ninth. This game a little over 3 hours old. And we've had quite a bit of everything. 25 hits combined. Just low right there. Count goes to 2-2. 24 runs combined as well. The 2-2. Tipped into the glove for strike three. So that'll do it for the Warhawks, but they had a run on what was a very loud hit over the left field wall. And another runner left on base. How about that? We head to the bottom of the ninth. Chargers trailing at 15-9 here on 97.7 ESPN The Zone.
At Bryant Bank, we believe your goals are worth chasing, and every step along the way is worth celebrating. From your hopes for the future to the challenges that keep you up at night, we're here for you. Bryant Bankers put care into action to help you live legendary by stepping up when you need us most and doing what's right even when no one is watching. Come experience a local bank whose people greet you by name and treat you like family. Bryant Bank, member FDIC.
Tom Luganville here for my friends at Woody Anderson Ford. Bobby White and his team take great pride in their service department, and you can see it the moment you walk into those beautiful new service lanes. And just like a championship team, they all work together to make sure your experience is second to none, whether you drive a Ford or not. Also, check out the gold certified pre-owned inventory at Woody Anderson Ford for great deals every day. Stop by and see them at Jordan and Sparkman or at Woody Anderson of Madison on Hughes Road, or visit WoodyAndersonFord.com.
97.7 ESPN The Zone.
Bottom of the ninth we go. Chargers trailing at 15-9. Getting a visit from a ladybug. I'm going to take that as a good sign. But I'd like to know how in the heck that mosquito is still living up there. Tad chilly here in North Alabama, but my wife is of the opinion that ladybugs are good luck. So 9-1-2 are due up for the Chargers here. Let's see how we start off inning number 9 in there for a strike to Wendell, the Chargers shortstop. The 0-1 outside for ball one. The 1-1, knee buckler in there tight to the right-handed batter for strike two. The 1-2, fouled away, count stays at 1-2. So the only thing we have not seen here today is a triple. I feel like we've seen just about everything else. That's launched down the right field line and squeezed by the right fielder for out number one. I was trying to speak it into existence. And we've had a total of 3 home runs in the game, 1 for the Chargers, 2 for the Warhawks. Get over, Top of the order here, due up. Carter takes a look at ball one. Chargers down to our final two outs in this non-conference matchup. The 1-0. Inside for ball two. The 2-0. Inside for ball three. In there for strike one. Now goes to 3-1 to the Chargers leadoff hat. And he'll drill it towards right field. That is back and that is gone. A leadoff home run. Well, excuse me, a one-out home run for Merrick Carter here in the ninth. It is now 15-10. We just need five more of those for the home run derby. Okay, I'll be greedy. How about six more of those? Time for Caruso. Takes a look at ball one inside. Joey with his first hit as a collegiate player in his last at-bat. Later scored on that two-run blast by Presley Walker. The 2-0 in there for called strike one. Lee continues his work out on the mound. He kicks in, fires. That's launched to right field. Home run derby continue. No, it hits the base of the wall. And stopping at second base for a one-out double. So, hand the baton off. Home plate umpire says, give me some more baseballs. There comes Colin Bader for his second at-bat. He struck out in his first at-bat last inning. That's right up the gut, but gobbled up by the second baseman on first in time for the 4-3 put out. And the Chargers, we are down to our final out. Runner does advance to third on the put out. Presley Walker. His first home run of the year and his last at bat. And here's the pitch. It's outside for ball one. Second pitch high and inside for ball two. Trying to remember the Philly player that has that as his walk-up song. The 2-0. Inside for ball three. In there for strike one. Look a little inside from my vantage point. The 3-1 tipped off the end of the bat. And count runs full. Down to our final strike. Chargers trailing it 15-10. A full count pitch down the left field line, but scooped up by the third baseman on to first, and the scoop not made. E5 on that one, I would assume. Play continues. Run scores. It's now 15-11. So here comes Ramey Harrison. It is 50, yes. Two errors apiece now, as that is a fair ball down the first baseline. Rounding second, heading for third. And heading home, will there be a play at the plate? There will not. It's 15-12. So an RBI base hit down the right field line. Actually, it's a double. What am I saying? An unearned run, though, for Lee. And that brings up Hunter Nolan. The potential tying run is on deck for the UAH Chargers here in the ninth. It is 15-12. Lee having a conversation. Pitching coach there for AUM. The long homestand will continue this weekend. Just keep your eyes and ears peeled for potential weather issues on Friday. The Chargers scheduled to be home here against Montevallo. If we really do come back, then and credit the ladybug here right to my left. The pitch in there for strike one. The 0-1 to Nolan. Low and inside for ball one. Wonder if that conversation said, just throw some strikes and let's get on the bus. And if you lay a fat one right down the heart of the plate, it'll be a one-run game, the 1-1. In there for strike two, and again, the Chargers were down to our final strike. Long look at the wristband on the left wrist for Lee. The 1-2 pitch. Low, ball two. Chargers have already scored three times here in the ninth, and we need three more to tie things up. A 2-2 pitch. Here it comes from Lee with two outs in the ninth. Inside for ball three. And one more bad one here would send the tying run to home plate. The 3-2. It hit him. Here comes the tying run up to home plate. With two outs here in the bottom of the ninth. Oh, I was waiting on purpose, Cachopio, because I didn't want to mess that up again. Here's the pitch to Cachopio. Takes a look at strike one. If he hits a home run right here, Lord of mercy. The 0-1 swung on and missed. Boy, he was... You could tell he was aiming for the fence right there. Down to our final strike again for the third consecutive batter. The 0-2 from Lee. In the dirt and outside for ball one. Cachopio waiting on his pitch. He is the tying run. Down by three. It's 15-12. here at Charger Park. The 1-2 into right field, and it will land for a base hit, and one run will score. It's 15-13. Cacioppo with his first hit, and he gets an RBI as well. So now the winning run is Chase Upton. Upton can walk it off if he so chooses. Here's the pitch. High and outside for ball one. Boy, the shadows are now engulfing just about the entire infield. The 1-2, or excuse me, the 1-0 rather, in there for strike one. Count goes to 1-1. Two on, two out. We've already scored four here in the ninth. Winning run is swinging the bat right now. The 1-1, low and inside for ball two. Wendell is on deck. The 2-1. Outside for ball three. The lights are illuminating. Down by two. The 3-1. Ball four. The winning run is at first base. Here comes Hugh. Where the heck's my ladybug? There's the pitch to Wendell. High and inside for ball one. Four runs have scored for the Chargers here in the ninth, and we're down by two. The 1-0. Right down the heart of the plate for strike one to the Chargers shortstop. Twenty-nine hits combined. That's low for ball two. There's my ladybug. 28 runs, 29 hits, four errors combined. The 2-1 waved at and miss, and I'll say it for the fourth time. Chargers down to our final strike. The 2-2 pitch from Lee. Here it comes. Little number to second, scooped up onto second, and that will do it as the rally is squashed and AUM comes to Huntsville and pulls off a 15-13 win over the Chargers. For AUM, 15 runs on 12 hits and two errors. For the Chargers, 13 runs on 17 hits and two errors. Wow. Just wow. Chargers will be back home this weekend, weather pending. There is supposed to be some rain.